Okay, to create animation simply and automatically, you just take the puppet and a character animator, and you create the action script to export the art to the illustrator. In there, we rig the character in a special way with a bunch of lawyers for rigging the next program, which is a character animator. Now, we have 8 puppets and 1 across 3 different programs, so we are ready to pull about 6 billion MIDI controls that we need to control each part of the body across all the different positions. That allows us to spin the extra custom code that will recognize the human in the video, and we will create the skeletons that will represent the movement. We grab the skeleton and create MIDI signals to control the character in a character animator.
But there's about a billion controls in there. So it works very slowly, plus MIDI signals have limitations. You really need to send it one at a time. It makes it hard to control. I think we need to get rid of the crazy person and simplify.
Today we'll cover how to simplify the motion capture project and we will move to Adobe Animate. But calling it Adobe Animate is cringe, so we will call it Flash. The first thing that sparked all the changes was this button in Flash. If we go to the commands menu, we can see that export and import of the motion are both possible. I don't want this video to be a Flash tutorial though, so we will only cover the main ideas. In the bottom, we can see the timeline with a bunch of elements marked as head, arm, near, etc. Those are parts of the body that we can control. There are benefits in the Flash as opposed to in character animator, so let's review a couple of them. First of all, it allows us to control the art directly. So if we have the recognitions that we done or we have the performance that we recorded and some frames or some parts look a little bit off, it's very easy for us to adjust in the Flash because it's art that we can move. Or we can even swap the body parts with the new ones or even redraw them completely. It's a very free program in this way, where the character animator, it's kind of, okay, one piece of art, one piece of character, and you get what you get. Secondly, controls are much more precise. For example, in the MIDI range that we use to control the character, it's 0 to 127 to describe the complete rotation, and in here it's 0 to 360. And because of that, we can be much more precise with our controls. And lastly, we avoid a lot of issues that had to do with the recording themselves. The position of the body is very weird and we have to be very time sensitive. And with MIDI values, we cannot really send them all at the same time. So we have to do joint by joint, and in here we can import everything in bulk. The complete process basically allows us to work with animation traditionally after we created the initial animation. So we're creating the rough pass with motion capture and then we clean it as we're working with the usual animation. But since we are automating the process, all automations are reusable. So if we create a walking cycle for one puppet, we will be able to automate another puppet even if it looks way different. This is extremely convenient for the game development where you may need a lot of NPCs that may walk similarly, and I do need the 40 NPCs, so I definitely cannot spend 2 weeks on each puppet. I made a couple of adjustments to the code already, so I can create this XML motion file in Flash, but I'm still working on how exactly I'm gonna do it, but this will be much more simple process where we have one program and we will be able to automate everything inside it by using the Python scripts and the automation options that Flash provides to us. Because of the process, we also need to revise the puppet. For now, I'm using the template largely based on the Skynamic Studios tutorials, but we will need to redraw it in a way that's more suitable for automation, and we will see what limitations are out there and how to work with it better. And a couple of comments on the puppet itself. So for now, we create the puppet, and it's essentially one big symbol that we will be using, and we can zoom in inside by double-clicking, and we can see the different body parts, and we can move it around, rotate, shear, and scale. If I double click though, I can enter the symbol and now I can see all the nested body parts. And all the body parts are also nested inside, so we will have to figure it out how to work with it specifically down the line. First, I need to figure out how exactly is it automatable and what exactly is the code adjustments that I need to do, because so far my experiments were kind of here and there. We will control the body parts inside the symbol to animate the body movement. And at the end, we will have the puppet where each body part will be animated individually, but because they're all nested inside each other, it all actually works together and we hope to keep joints on the same place. Lots of things to cover, so join me here or Twitter, Discord, Where did my coffee go?
My name's Joey, but I'm not an addict.
Jeez.
No, really. Listen, look. I got in trouble with my computer, right? Okay? My lawyer told the judge that I'm an addict, but I'm not addicted to my computer. No, really. I'm not an addict. I'm not. Can I get some more coffee?